that's when all of those rich Pluto capitalists did their trading in there. So it's not just going to be in the Lady Mayoress's parlour, it's going to be in Shea Stevens.
Wow. Thank you very much.
So congratulations.
Thank you.
Gemma?
Have I ever been few?
Well, no.
Thanks very much, everyone. And thanks for this model. It's, I suppose it's a kind of equivalent to your photographs, really. And I don't know whether you get to thinking on days like this. And I was remembering one of the first times I did a tour here. It must have been the end of 1990. And they were Danish students. If you've heard this, you have to apologise. I have to apologise. But they were Danish students, and I'd been in the pub with them all day, and I knew they spoke better English than me. And we walked around, it must have been about 7 o'clock, and it was like September or October, 7 in the evening. And they were shuffling along behind me. I thought, what is wrong with this lot, you know? So we got back to the front door, and the Mackie was on the door in those days, said to me, Steve, we've let you down, we forgot to put the lights on. And I'd taken them round in the dark. And I always remembered that. I mean, this building, particularly this building, I'm not, has made a massive difference to my life. I would have studied history anyway, because that's what I always did. Not at school, I didn't like school as much, but the fact that I suddenly ended up taking people around this building and was able to study my city's history. Not because I'm not one of these, like, you know, Liverpool is the centre of the universe historians. To me, I studied history first and then fitted Liverpool into it, which is really, I think, what we should really do. And to think that I was able to do that. And just as a secondary thing, the idea that without haranguing or shouting at people, and I've done my fair share of that, as people in here will know, but just by going about your business and just doing what you do, you can remove this kind of tragic element that some people have of any person who has any sort of disability. And so that just by doing what you do, and the fact that for an hour and a half, I couldn't see this building, but I was in charge of people who could. As a secondary, and it's not as important as the history, nothing is, but as a secondary aspect to it, I was always conscious of that when doing my tours. I wanted to have that effect, not on my behalf, but on behalf of thousands of other people. And I just want to end just by thanking you all. And I just want to say to Gemma and Rihanna and Rosemary and Tanya, if they're here, that there is no way that if they ask me to do something that I will actually refuse. How could anybody suddenly stop talking about his favourite subject after all these years? So I'm not going very far. I only know the 14 bus anyway. So, so I'm not going very far, and will always be nearby. And you don't suddenly stop studying. Just finally, one final story, and you can forgive me. There was an occasion, I don't know what year it was, but Mike Storey was the leader. It was one of those years. And I was doing some tours in St. George's on a Sunday, and they were doing some work on the William Brown Street Museum. And they actually, this is us by the way, we actually employed somebody to patrol the steps to tell people it wasn't open. So they got this letter, and he sent this letter to the council leader. And this guy from Manchester had said, he'd come to Liverpool to go to the museum, and he found it was shut. And he looked across the road there and he'd seen this building, St George's Road, and he'd gone in and he said there was a tour. So he said, I'll go on it. And then he said, this is the bit I loved. In the middle of the group, there was a poor blind man looking mournful. Well, we just lost to Sheffield Wednesday 3-1. And he said, all of a sudden, he tapped his stick on the floor and he shouted, come on, you lot, or we'll never get home. And he was in charge of me for the next hour and a half. And I like that letter. I like that letter. It appealed to me. So, look, thanks very much, everyone. And this model, I shall find a place amongst my cats.